Hey, it's Dr. Scott. Part of my job is to give you a weekly study tips video real fast. We can always talk more in office hours and in the test prep. But for chapters 1 and 2, we've got two families to discuss, the whole family and the Ma family. The whole family are Swedish immigrants. They're coming from this part of Europe, Sweden. And as you can see by these big black arrows, a huge number of Swedish immigrants came through places like New York, which is exactly where Nicole's ancestor comes. They land here in New York, and then they come out here to Iowa. And you can see by this map, Swedish immigration in the US, vast numbers of Swedish immigrants came and started farms all across the Midwest, what's called the Midwest, and the Western United States. And Nick's family is just like that. What they bring with them is chestnuts, and chestnuts were the dominant tree species in the eastern part of the United States. So here's New York. You can see the chestnuts, 4 billion of them, the dominant tree. All the way across the eastern part of the United States. Beautiful, incredible, huge trees. This is a large chestnut tree in comparison to a two-story building. As you can see, they were known as the redwoods of the East for good reason. And huge numbers of families went out and gathered chestnuts, including Nick's ancestor, gathered chestnuts, the chestnuts, the nuts, the delicious nuts that fall out of these giant trees. So he brings with him to Iowa. A couple chestnuts, plants them, and out of this grows these giant trees. And of course, that's not Nicole's family, but it is something like his family and something like the size of the giant tree that he grew up under. And although chestnuts were deeply damaged by logging operations prior to the 1900s, the chestnut blight, which you'll hear about, and that's a fungus that attacks the chestnuts, it was a tree pandemic, and it wiped out 4 billion chestnut trees all across the United States, in wave after wave after wave after wave, until basically chestnuts were nearly, not quite, but nearly extinct. And that's where our story ends up later in the book. Now, the Ma family in chapter 2 similarly immigrate from long, long way. First, all the way from Persia here as Muslim immigrants to China on the right side of the screen, and bringing with them along what was called the Silk Roads, mulberry trees that are used to make silk, which was part of the rich trade between Central Asia and China for century after century after century, dynasty after dynasty. So that by the time 1949 comes along and the Chinese Communist Revolution is just about to happen, in this period, as this slide shows from a scholarly document, whoops, let me back up here for you. In this period before 1949, Muslims owned approximately 50% of the shops selling jewelry, antiques, tea, cotton, marble, jade, and calligraphy. And there's still mosques in Shanghai to this day. And those families are named, in fact, Ma and Hui. So the large merchant families are accurately named in the book. Now, again, this is only vaguely true, just as with Nicole's family. It's all made up, it's all fiction, but it's based on real history. That's part of what I'm trying to get across to you. So when the son of the Ma family, who's a struggling young engineering student, flees to San Francisco to escape the Chinese Communist Revolution, which nationalizes his family's fortune. He brings with him these scrolls and these kinds of scrolls. This isn't obviously the same scroll, but these kinds of scrolls and 3 jade rings, and all of the family's wealth is in these incredibly valuable art objects. And this is a Chinese scroll painting, of course, of a scholar seeking enlightenment under a tree with a poem over in the corner, which is the sort of thing vaguely that the Ma family has inherited, and they've also inherited a love for mulberry trees. So that I hope that this gives you an idea of the crucial importance of trees in the overstory, the crucial importance of immigrant history in the overstory, and the ways that the roots of these things as immigration routes, as immigration routes, as the roots of trade, as the roots of even things like blight and tree pandemics are impacting the way that things happen under the giant overstory that is the title of the book.